A very good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Neha Dubey from MBA SIRT Bhopal. Today, I'm going to discuss the one of the basic, very basic and important topic of the research methodology of MBA second semester, that is sampling and its types. So what do you understand by the sampling and population sampling? So first, we need to cover the basic terminologies, population, sample, and sampling, advantages and disadvantages of the sampling, and the kinds of sampling, that is probability and non-probability. This lecture will be covered in two parts. So we start from the basic terminology, that is the population or universe. It refers to the group of people, items, or units under investigation and includes every individual. Sample, a collection consisting of a part or a subset of an object or an individual of a population which is selected for the purpose representing the population. And sampling, it is a process of selecting the sample from the population. And for this population is divided into a number of small parts that is called the sampling units. So now we will explain it in a very simple manner. When you wanted to test certain things, so you just wanted to ask a small sample or part of a whole lot so that you can check it, the whole lot is a good or not. We can take an example here. If you wanted to check a quality of a wheat in the whole lot or packet of a wheat, so what do you check? So you just ask for the small sample from the different varieties so that you can identify the which one is a good. So the small portion is considered as a sample and the whole lot is considered as a population. So I think it may be clear to you now. And sampling is just a process of selecting a sample through various techniques. Here is a diagrammatic representation that the small sample circle, that is a blue in color, is considered a small portion that comes into the category of a target population, and the target population comes in the whole population. So first you need to identify the whole population, then you have to focus on a target population where you are going to select the certain part, that is your sample. Now, need of sampling. Why we require the sampling? Large population cannot be conveniently covered. First thing, time, money, and energy is saved in this method when we do the sampling. Helpful when units of an area are homogeneous. It will be good for a homogeneous criteria. And homogeneous is what? It's the same kind of a features. Used when the percent accuracy is not required and used when the data is unlimited. Now, the advantages of sampling is economical, reduce the cost compared to entire population. When we go for data collection to the one-to-one person, so it will be the very time taking and the cost taking process. So the sampling is a help for reducing the cost for containing and getting the representing data, that is the sample from the whole population. Increased speed, collection of a data, analysis and interpretation of a data, etc. take less time than the population. Accuracy, due to limited area of a coverage, completeness and accuracy is possible. Rapport, that is a better rapport is established with the respondents and which helps in the validity and reliability of the results. Because if you wanted to, for example, you are getting the data from a personal interview or the survey method, so you interact with the one-to-one person and it will help to develop a good relations as well, and it will assure you the reliability and the validity of a data. Now, the disadvantages of sampling is biasedness. Chances of a biased selection leading to the incorrect conclusion, it is very much possible in this kind of a sampling. Selection of a true representative sample. Sometimes it is difficult to select the right representative sample. Need for specialized knowledge. The researcher needs knowledge, training, and experience in sampling techniques, statistical analysis, and calculation of a probable error. Impossibility of a sampling. Sometimes population is too small or too heterogeneous to select a representative sample. Now, what is the characteristics of a good sample? A true representative of a population, free from error due to the bias, adequate in size for being reliable. It is a very much finding that in certain cases, the population criteria is too much in related to our research topic. But when we select the sample, so we are just taking the very small size. So that cannot be considered as a good sample size, and it cannot be adequate for the considering and finding universally. Right. So you have to follow the formula for identifying the sample as per the population size. Unit of a sample should be independent and relevant. Units of a sample should be complete, precise, and up to date, free from random sampling error, and avoiding substituting the original sample for convenience. So this is for today's lecture only. This is the basics of a sampling. Then we will discuss the probability and non-probability, that is the types of a sampling techniques. So thank you and have a nice day. Hopefully you will be able to understand what I'm trying to say there. So thanks.